Hey, welcome everybody to Spotlight. This is a show by Cameras Africa. We are a store selling photography and filming equipment, and this is our show that we have now introduced. We saw a demand from our customers, a lot of them asking for training, need to know what's happening, and we have also seen a lot of our customers who have grown and they want to impart their knowledge. And there was no platform such as this showcasing them, and that is why we have decided to start this show. Today with me we have Steve Deritu, who has been the PAK chairman from 2012 to 2017. We can say he was the founding chairman, the first chairman, and we shall hear from him as to what he has experienced from 2012 to 2019, and while he was also the PAK, how it has grown. Well, Steve.
Okay. First of all, thank you very much for having me on this first edition, because there is a growing need to share information amongst photographers, filmmakers, or videographers, as some of them call themselves. And straight to answer your question is that we have seen tremendous growth in the industry. We have seen expansion of opportunities. We have seen growth in numbers in terms of the people who are involved in photo and filmmaking and video. And I think there are four things that I would say I have noticed. Availability of equipment and gear for a lot of people. From the time when I started in the late 2000s and today, with vendors like you and others, there is a availability of equipment, even access to e-commerce online. So you find that people are able to do more things, which is a good thing. The second thing is that the younger generation has come into the industry. It has come into the industry with a lot of energy, with fresh ideas. So we are seeing a lot of young people interested in making videos, films, music videos, taking pictures and photography. The other thing that I have noticed is learning opportunities, which have come, good thing and a bad thing, because we have too many photographers, we have a lot of people doing video. So I don't know who are the real ones, who are the professional ones. And the last thing is, the growth of social media has given us a lot of opportunities. You know, social media has created a lot of opportunities. I'm sure even the people who come to buy cameras, they want to do vlogs, they want to be YouTubers and things like that. So you find that there's a lot of companies and businesses want pictures. So those are some of the things that I've noticed that have happened in the recent past in the industry.
Yes, it's interesting you're saying social media, because we have also seen a trend that, you know, a lot of our customers are wanting to take better photos for Instagram. You know, they are traveling more, so they want to take good photos, good pictures. And now that there are a lot of platforms where they can share, you know, for photos, there's Instagram, Facebook. Yes. If they take videos, they want to start their YouTube channel, let people know what they're doing. And that has, I think, also increased. But at the same time, there's also, we are seeing a need for knowledge on how to improve their skills. You know, after they've got the cameras, after they've started using it, they say, okay, how do I improve myself? How do I improve myself?
Yes. And there's definitely a lot of thirst and need for knowledge. I think that's where, like one of the things that we've been doing under Photo Kenya, which I also run, especially since I left office at Photographers Association, we've been doing a lot of training since 2013, end of 2013 to date. And many other people have come up to fill that gap in terms of training. And I think even some of the industry players that we work with have been doing a lot of workshops. Even colleges have come up that are teaching more. And we've seen even learning institutions, that maybe the older universities and colleges, trying to partner so that they can get more information that is up to date. And definitely we have the other gang that jumps to YouTube straight, but you'll find that a lot of professionals, you know, guys in corporate affairs, communication, offices, in the businesses, they want to come and meet other people and learn alongside in a practical setting. Yes.
Yeah, saying that universities, also last year we did a couple of workshops with the universities. Yes. The students were excited to get knowledge from and learn about the latest technology from us. Yes. We have been lucky to partner up with vendors like Canon, yes, who are supporting with their education. They have started Canon Academy, and you know, they their goal is to teach people, yes, how to use the equipment. And we have seen that that is an approach that also we as Cameras Africa want to take. You know, we don't want to just be guys who sell you equipment and that's it.
I think that is the same thing that you have the series even with the Talanta Institute.
Yes, so that's what we are doing with Talanta. We are having one workshop every month with them. Yeah. And we're also planning to increase the number of workshops we have every month. We're hoping that we can do at least two workshops from, you know, the existing industry leaders and players now. And this year we are not going to limit ourselves to photography only. We also want to start doing filming.
Okay. Oh, that is good. But is there any opportunity for younger people, you know, like high school or secondary schools and the younger people? Anything in the plan for that, or that is maybe to come later?
For high school students, we have not done with the students. We are working and teaching the teachers.
Yeah, teachers, yes.
So that they can teach. Because now, with the National Drama and Film Festival, every year since the past 6 years, there are being films that have entered also. You know, which is growing every year in numbers. So we are trying to teach the teachers so that they can improve the quality of films.
Quality of what they are producing.
Yes. Yeah. After PAK, then you know, you also have Photomagic.
Yes.
And now you have also started Karakana.
Yes.
Please explain what Karakana is all about and what you're doing there.
In my own terms, maybe Karakana is one of those projects that I have been intending to do, looking at the what we call the creative economy. Some people call it the creative industry. It's a very wide industry. It could be music, could be dance, could be poetry, could be visual arts, could be design, fashion, interiors, and many others. So we want to add to the efforts that are already being put in the creative industry to try and improve it, whether on education, on policy, whether on mentorship and just exchange of ideas and helping artists to be better, to be more effective, to earn better livelihoods, to make money, to learn from each other. And hopefully we will just make the world a better place. So that is what we are doing. And we've started with what we are calling the Karakana Creative Dialogues, which gives an opportunity for including even just something like this, to just sit and talk and get to learn from one another.
That's, I think the first one that you did was very interesting. It's called Mental Health,
yes,
for Creatives.
Yes.
Maybe you can explain a bit on why that was necessary to do.
I think we, as creatives in this country, we are walking on rough terrain, you know. With not as much support from government as we should. People don't understand us. Many of the creatives in this country, we are broke. There is no support system, so you find that stress levels are just generally higher than normal. And then at the same time, we are caught in between being very talented, but not making money. We are very talented, we have amazing work, people praise us, but I may have to ask you for 100 bob so that I can take a matatu back home. So it's just one of the many voices about mental health in creative industry that we are trying to add.
So you have Creative Dialogues, we have this, and I think it's a very good
very good initiative.
And one of the things that we like to do, which you also do, and that is why we are together sitting, is collaboration. We, you know, I think both of us share the same thing. If two people are doing the same, there's no need to duplicate.
No.
Come together, collaborate, and make it better.
I think in the industry it is very important. I have been in a position to see in the Kenyan creative industry, not just photography, not in filmmaking, not in visual arts, across the board. Everybody is trying to do the same thing, but in a silo format, what they call a silo format. So you sit there, you do the thing, I sit here, but the end result is we are going to the same destination. And I think that is why, like you have said, people need to work together. We are not competing.
Yes.
We are not competing. I have seen even currently, look at what's happening in the music industry. You know, those who are collecting the benefits, the money for the music. It's like they are fighting. They can't agree. You know, it's tragic, and it's because the music industry is bigger. But you'll find the same challenges even to the smaller, less known creative industries. So collaborations are very important. And even I want to ask, you know, like photographers, those in Nairobi, they need to be under one umbrella. The filmmakers, those producing content for TV, they need to work together. They need to work together even with those government bodies that we don't like sometimes. You know, perhaps they just need to work together, and it is very important.
I think that only then we can maximize on the, you know, they say one mind is better than two.
Yes.
So, you know, there might be something you're good at, I'm good at, and we're both trying to do the same thing. Time, resources, money, a lot of things, you know, are duplicated.
One effort, the two people, the three people you know, and the two people and the three people I know, if we come together, then it means we know more people, we'll reach more people together as compared to if people work alone.
But, see now, do you think that mentality is now being accepted, collaboration, where we have come together to do this show so that, you know, you don't duplicate what is happening here and I don't duplicate, and I'm getting guys who are ready to do workshops, part knowledge to the upcoming.
It's a journey. Yeah. It's a journey. I think it's a giant we are trying to defeat, and it's going to be a journey slow by slow. But we've started. I think we've started looking at what, for example, you know, Cameras Kenya is doing. You know, if you're working with Canon, if you're working with Talanta, if you're working with high school teachers for film, if you're working with the high schools, if you're working with the colleges, if you're working with other associations, that's where it starts, you know. And the next time we will have people in your position who are providing services and goods to our industry, going to other people, and they all come together and do great things. And I think if we are able to achieve this amount this year, next year it doubles, in 3-5 years, we will be talking about a very strong creative force in this country, not just in photography, not just in TV and film, but across the whole of the creative industry.
Thank you, Steve, for coming on the show. Let us move and have a good year ahead.
Yes.
Thank you.